An electric revolution is underway at GM. Globally, the automaker plans to introduce some 30 new EVs by the year 2025. And that, of course, includes both of these cars right here. We've got the updated 2022 Chevrolet Bolt EV, and then the brand new Bolt EUV, or electric utility vehicle. And here's the scoop on both of these machines. Oh, and one other thing, I just ate a chicken shawarma with extra sauce on it, so I am wearing double masks right now, both to protect my coworkers from coronavirus and garlic breath.
The updated Bolt EV and the new Bolt EUV are part of GM's grand plan to put everyone in an electric car. They foreshadow the tsunami of EVs this company is set to launch in the coming years. These mass-market vehicles are built on the same architecture and look quite similar, however, no sheet metal is shared. The Bolt EUV is a bit more muscular and has a unique front end with standard LED headlights. It's also about 6 inches longer than its sibling. The regular Bolt's front end has also been tweaked with a more upright fascia. The lighting signatures have been redone too, but it still looks, well, pretty much the same.
As you can see, these are both happy, cheerful cars with bright, broad, smiling front ends, though unfortunately they don't really break any new design ground. I mean, the Chevy Bolt's been on the market for a few years now, and the Bolt EUV is just kind of a riff on that, so the overall shape is pretty familiar. And I don't really think they're any more attractive than some of the competitors that are on the market right now. So what do these vehicles compete with? Well, the EUV, you could argue, might rival the BMW i3 or possibly even the Hyundai Kona Electric. As for the Bolt EV, Nissan Leaf is its major competitor. Then, of course, you've got the Tesla Model 3 and the Model Y and the Mustang Mach-E, which are all much more attractive, I think, than these cars, though they're not necessarily direct competitors. Those vehicles, I think, are a tier or two above what Chevy is offering here.
Inside, both cars feature a new instrument panel that's way nicer than before. The design looks more upscale, and the materials used are far better. A Honda-esque electronic shifter with buttons and toggles is included, a design that takes up less room. A flat-bottom steering wheel adds a dash of sportiness and incorporates a regen on-demand paddle, though a one-pedal driving button is also included for maximum energy recuperation. Thanks to that elongated body, the Bolt EUV has more interior space, around 3 additional inches of backseat legroom. When it comes to creature comforts, a panoramic sunroof is offered on the EUV, as are heated and ventilated front seats, as well as heated outboard rear seats. Now let's talk about circuits and such. A 10.2-inch touchscreen with integrated climate controls is standard on both vehicles, as is an 8-inch digital instrument cluster. As you'd expect, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto are included. The wireless charging plate is available on the Bolt EV, though it is standard on the EUV. But the biggest tech news here is the availability of Super Cruise, GM's brilliant hands-free driving aid, which works on more than 200,000 miles of highway in the US and Canada. It's available on the Bolt EUV, the first time a Chevy can be had with Super Cruise, but if you want it on the standard Bolt EV, well, you're out of luck. Of course, plenty of other driver aids are standard on both cars, things like automatic high beams, lane keeping assist, and front pedestrian braking. Other features like rear cross traffic alert, a 360-degree camera system, and adaptive cruise control are available.
But one area where you don't get any choice is under the hood. Just one powertrain is offered, a single motor drive unit that should provide 200 horsepower and 266 pound-feet of torque. Now, that is enough pork and beans to get you to 60 miles per hour in about 6.5 seconds for the Bolt EV, though the EUV here, since it's a little bit bigger, will probably be a tick or two slower than that. But in any event, performance should be very good because torque, and lots of it right down low.
As for the all-important question of range, the Bolt EV should once again be able to go 259 miles on a single charge. Despite being taller, longer, and slightly heavier, the Bolt EUV can still manage a respectable 250 miles between fill-ups, juice-ups, I guess? Both vehicles feature a 65 kilowatt-hour lithium-ion battery pack. For added convenience, a new dual-level charge cord is available on the EV and standard on the EUV. It allows you to juice up from either a 120-volt household outlet or a 240-volt plug at up to 7.2 kilowatts. Both models support level 2 charging at up to 11 kilowatts and can absorb around 100 miles of range in 30 minutes when hooked to a DC fast charger. Use a plain old 120-volt outlet and you get just 4 miles per hour. Ain't nobody got time for that. Obviously, the 2022 Chevy Bolt EUV is big news, but pricing may be more significant. You see, before any discounts or tax credits, both models cost less than the outgoing 2021 Bolt EV. Including destination charges, the EUV starts at $33,995, while the EV kicks off at just $31,995, which is a reduction of more than $5,000. With an asterisk. You see, it looks like the 2021 Bolt already has some huge cash allowances, so it seems like Chevy is kind of rolling those into the price.
And there's nothing wrong with that. Both 2022 Bolts are strong values with their good driving range, much improved interiors, and of course the availability of Super Cruise on the EUV model, which is kind of the killer app here. GM's all-electric offensive will hopefully be off to a good start when these cars go on sale, which should be this summer.